If you're building an investment portfolio, it's a good idea to include some assets that are linked to inflation. What you will find, however, is that while some assets, such as government index-linked gilts, are linked to the older retail price index, other assets, such as national savings certificates, are linked to the newer consumer prices index. Does it really make any difference? Both indices, after all, are trying to do the same thing. They're trying to measure the rate of increase of prices. However, we do note that RPI normally comes out a little bit ahead. It's to do with the method of its construction, and typically it comes out about 0.5% per annum higher than CPI. Does this make a difference if you're investing over the short term for a year or two? Probably not. But if you're investing over the long term, it could become quite significant. A way of seeing just how significant that difference is to look at the published accounts of banknote printer De La Rue, who have recently switched their final salary pension scheme from RPI indexation to CPI indexation. This led their actuaries to recalculate the scheme liabilities, and they took a cool £80 million off the liabilities of a scheme that previously had totaled £1 billion. That's an 8% difference, which I think means that over the course of their lifetime, the members are now going to be 8% worse off than they would have been if RPI indexation had been retained. The moral of the story is that a lot of little differences over a long period of time can add up to quite a significant difference.